Even death couldn't separate Jackie Mogridge from her favourite plane, the very same Spitfire that marked the beginning of her distinguished flying career 60 years ago, was with her to the very end as it scattered her ashes over Dunkerswell Airfield near Taunton yesterday.
I don't feel sad, I feel absolutely thrilled because it will mean that Mummy has been set free by the aeroplane that she loved the most.
Jackie Mogridge died earlier this year, aged 81. In her 20s, she was one of just a handful of wartime female pilots who delivered hundreds of fighter planes to RAF squadrons. Her first delivery, the Spitfire, taking part in yesterday's ceremony. It was the first to shoot down an enemy aircraft during the D-Day landings. Speaking on ITV West 10 years ago, she said the wartime life had been incredibly exciting.
To me, it was the most wonderful, unexpected experience of my whole life. And I really think, you know, although I love my children and my husband and everything, I really think from the sheer excitement of it all, it was the best part of my life, and that was 5 years of it.
After the war, Jackie Mogridge continued to fly professionally for more than 40 years. She was one of the first women to break the sound barrier and went on to enjoy a successful career flying passenger planes.
She used to have to not speak over the intercom because in those days women pilots were very rare and it would have made the people nervous to think they were being flown by a woman. So the second pilot used to speak and welcome the passengers on board.
Fighter pilots saved Britain from Hitler and seaborne invasion by winning superiority in the air. Both Jackie Mogridge and the Spitfire played their parts in making that victory possible. Dominic Velaitis, ITV West News.